Permission granted. Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance. Join me. Please remove your caps and hats in the audience. All right. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Thank you. You may be seated.
Good morning and welcome, class of 2024, esteemed faculty, family, friends, and community members. My name is Hannah Jones, student body president of Sonoraville High School. And 12 years ago, we began our journey in the Gordon County school system, where timetables were our biggest struggle and dodgeball during PE was what we looked forward to every single day. 11. Was the age we learned to hit the quan, juju on that beat, and most importantly, dab in every single classroom photo. Trust me, I have proof. However, dabbing can only stay cool for so long as we began our journey through middle school to high school and finally to our senior year, where there were 10 football games. We proudly cheered on the Phoenix. From being down by 30 to being up by 50, we never lost our spirit. 9, the only amount of yards the class of 2024 Powderpuff team could only seem to manage every year, until this one. You're welcome, Coach Mashburn. 8, Times I had to help my brother turn in his dual enrollment assignments on a Sunday night 30 minutes before 12 a.m. He owes me for life. 7, letters in the word Phoenix, our school mascot. One you'll remember forever because once a Phoenix, always a Phoenix. Be kind and make good choices. A 6-word phrase said by our principal, Miss Stewart, on the announcements every morning. 5, times I got quarantined freshman year because of COVID-19. Disaster after disaster, all encompassed in a global pandemic. That year helped us all realize that in life's toughest changes and challenges, unity is our strongest asset. We couldn't go through it alone. We have never gone through it alone, and we will never go through it all alone. After masks finally became non-mandated and our hybrid learning days came to an end, things started to seem normal again. We were able to fill our high school days with sports, theater, school clubs, homework, and friends for the next 4 years. Until those 4 years became 3 years, then 2, then 1, then 0. 0, we're here. 0, we're done. 0, we're at the end of the line. Sounds scary, doesn't it? Having to leave home and go to college, trade school, or even join the military. The worst part is your mom won't be there to do your laundry. Frightening. But you see, our culture puts so much emphasis on the end, the countdown, the big stop, that we miss out on what zero really is. I mean, look at it. It's not a big wall. It's a circle, a hole, a portal, an entrance. Zero is the beginning because on the other side, there is 1 step in front of the other, 2 eyes looking forward, 3.93 other students in the U.S. alone, million other students in the U.S. alone, who have come to the realization that you must say goodbye before you can say that 5-letter word to something greater than what has led you up to this moment. Change, a 6-letter word that can cause so much fear and trouble for people, including myself, who are not ready to embrace it. In reality, all the world knows how to do is change. And looking back, all we know how to do is change with it. And come out with something better than before. The Japanese have a saying, nana korbiya oki, which translates to, fall down 7 times, but get up 8. Which basically means, yeah, the world's changes will knock you down, but you'll always return to your standing position. And 9 times out of 10, the sun will be brighter and the grass will be greener on the other side. There's 7.18 billion people who share this blue marble in the universe with you, each with their own advice, stories, truths, jokes, songs, and questions to tell, sing, ask, and share. And all you have to do to hear them is just put yourself out there. And I could keep counting all the way up to the infinite number of possibilities for us, the one in a million miracles in our futures that are brighter than the billions of shining stars in the sky. So during our commencement, as you look at all our peers walking across this stage, don't think of it as saying goodbye to the memories, the friends, the sports, SHS, but of the infinite number of days ahead. So this isn't me saying goodbye to my friends, my school, my hometown, the last 18 years of my life, but instead I'm saying hello to what lies ahead, and you should too. To it lies on the other side of zero, because zero is not the end, it is only the beginning. Thank you, class of 2024, I love you all.
Thank you. Greetings, fellow classmates, and welcome to all proud parents, honored guests, and loyal and admired faculty. Thank you so much for joining the SHS Class of 2024 for this wonderful occasion. We will hear from several speakers today, and since this is graduation, I feel certain you will hear much about next steps, goals, and goal settings. After all, goals are important. President Reagan once discussed the importance of goals, of setting lofty goals that are hard to reach. He told about driving through a small town on an old and washed out dirt road. Maybe he was in Fairmount. He saw a chicken in the road, which also leads me to believe he really was in Fairmount. As he approached the chicken, it ran into the road and started running alongside his car. For fear of hitting the chicken, the president moved over and increased his speed to leave the chicken safely behind him. However, the chicken sped up too. So the president increased his speed again, and so did the chicken. As the president reached about 40 miles per hour, he noticed the chicken had three legs. And the three-legged chicken pulled out in front of President Reagan's car and made a hard right turn into a long driveway. The president followed and reached an old farmhouse. The farmer quickly came out and was surprised to find President Reagan in his muddy driveway. With no introductions required, President Reagan told the farmer about his experience with the three-legged chicken. The farmer explained to the president that he raised three-legged chickens with a goal to increase his chicken leg production. Impressed, the president asked the farmer how his chickens tasted. The farmer shrugged and replied that he didn't know because he had never been able to catch them. So, I hope you all set goals just like the president's three-legged chicken. I pray they are plentiful, lofty, and hard to catch, because those goals will be worth it when you do finally reach and catch them. So again, I know you will hear all about goals and next steps today, and I want to focus on three other aspects that are along a slightly different path. First, do not let anyone, including yourselves, diminish the magnitude of this accomplishment. Today is a wonderful day, and it is a wonderful accomplishment. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. I want to congratulate Paul on being our valedictorian, and it is a wonderful achievement. I think it came down to the wire, and he got me, but I was never sad about it. At an early age, Ricky Bobby's dad had him convinced that if you aren't first, then you're last. Ricky was disillusioned by this for decades. However, in the end, Ricky and his dad both learned there are a lot more options. There's second, there's third, and heck, there's even fourth. This might seem like a ridiculous example, but there's a real point. In the grand scheme of things, it doesn't matter how you stack against others. Be the best you that you can be, and the other things will take care of themselves. I'm proud of Paul that is graduating first, Carter that is third, and Hannah that is fourth, and everyone else here. Congratulations to every one of us. And by the way, I don't know who it is, but someone here is number 289. Do you know what they call the doctor that finishes dead last in medical school? They call him a doctor. So graduates, congratulations on your accomplishment. Second, I beg each of you to devote this day to being a turning point in your lives. This concept stems from the magnitude of this accomplishment that I just discussed. I encourage my fellow classmates to deflect the credit today for this wonderful accomplishment. Here's the reason. I want to thank teachers and coaches like Coach Mashburn that have prioritized their students and players above themselves. I didn't lose many high school tennis matches, but I lost two that were very big. Both of these two examples were season ending. They were both matches where, if I had won, our team would advance further into the playoffs. I will never forget the humbling, sad, and defeated feeling when these few points fell the wrong way, and I realized I had let down my teammates. It's a crippling weight that hits more suddenly than I can verbalize. In both cases, Coach Mashburn found me faster than I know how, put his arm around my shoulder, and assured me that he and my team were proud of my battle and our season. He worried more about me than about a win. Every single one of us have a teacher that has made a difference for us. They've gone to bat for us, they've stayed out late for us, and they've inspired us. Before you leave today, please find, thank, and give credit to those teachers for this milestone. The same goes for your family members. My parents and grandparents supported me in every way possible, financially, emotionally, physically, academically, with their time, with their prayers, and so much more. Mom, Dad, my grandparents, my church family, and others, thank you for everything. Likewise, class of 2024, each of you have family or friends that have been there for you, and at the least, this milestone would have been so much harder without their support. Please go to them and tell them how much you appreciate them. Make sure they know this honor belongs to them too. And of course, I know my God has watched over me for my entire life, even before I knew he was there. Please, before you let your head hit your pillow tonight, make sure to offer thanks to God for this wonderful accomplishment and milestone. I can't imagine having to go through life, its struggles, and its challenges without knowing that God is in control. Especially during this last year and with my college search, I have prayed for the wrong doors to be closed and the right doors to be open. Over and again, God has answered my prayers. Please remember to give him thanks. After all, getting through all those hard days, I knew I could do all things through Christ who strengthened me. It was his strength, not mine. And this is a perfect lead-in into my last challenge for you. You will face new struggles soon, and I beg you to keep plowing ahead. I've been reminded by others many times lately that I'm about to face new challenges and everything is not going to go my way. The Dean of Science at Truett McConnell has warned me that every college freshman hits a brick wall anywhere from 3 to 10 weeks into their first semester. Something goes wrong at home, something goes wrong in class, the workload gets too big, someone gets homesick, or for any of the million different reasons, there will be a brick wall that we will each encounter. Some students will give up and go home forever, and others will endure and move on. The brick walls will keep coming, but this team promised that they will get easier. This isn't because the brick walls get smaller, but it's because we get better at handling them. And this isn't just for college students. It will happen in the workforce, in tech school, in family life, in anywhere we go. It's even biblical. In 2 Corinthians 12, Paul says, "Therefore, so that I would not exalt myself, a thorn in my flesh was given to me, a messenger of Satan to torment me so that I would not exalt myself. Concerning this, I pleaded with the Lord 3 times that it would leave me." And many of us know the story. God didn't take away Paul's thorn, but instead God reminded Paul that his grace is sufficient for you, for his power is perfected in weakness. Where we are weak, he is strong. When you face your own brick walls, please don't give up. Rely on God, rely on family, and rely on friends. Let their strength shine and be a part of your life. Don't be ashamed of it. Just like Paul, boast in your willingness to depend on others when we are weak. In the same manner, also support those around you when they are struggling too. Help where you can, and I encourage you to remind them about Paul's account. In closing, I want to steal a quote from the 2020 valedictorian, one that shares my same last name. Just a note, he might have been valedictorian, but my GPA was higher than his. He said, "Fellow Phoenix, I love you and I miss you already. I will pray for you daily. I pray you reach and catch your worthwhile goals, and most importantly, I pray I see you all on the other side of eternity. Go Phoenix."
Good morning, everyone. My name is Paul Duhay, and I am honored and thankful for this opportunity to be able to speak before you all today. I'd first off like to just begin by saying congratulations to everyone here who's graduating. We've done it. We've reached the end of this chapter, and it's a big accomplishment. Everyone here has achieved such an honor through years of work and education, and of course, not everyone's route was the same. One person here today may be one of the first in their whole family to receive a diploma, but another person may be following a long lineage of relatives who have done so. But no matter the different upbringings or obstacles we faced, we're all here today for the same reason. We've reached the end, and for that, I'd like to say congratulations. But now that we are all here, I'd like to invite us all to take a moment and reflect on our journey. I want us to stop and think about the people who have stood out to us in our lives. And sure, some people have stood out because they've been athletic or smart or humorous, but I want us to look beyond that. I want us to look beyond the more materialistic side of things and look deeper into the heart. Let us look at those who stood out to us because of their values and character. And while I cannot speak for everyone here, I can speak in my own experience. And in my own experience, the people who have stood out to me in life share 2 common characteristics. One is earnestness, and the other is love. The earnest. The earnest take their work and career seriously. They're not willing to simply take the easy way in life or the path of least resistance. Instead, they constantly desire to improve and succeed in whatever they do. And they can be seen across all sorts of disciplines. In athletics, they are the people who are not simply satisfied with a spot on the team or participating. Instead, they actively work to excel in their sport and master their craft. In school, they are the people who are not willing to simply sit in class and pass their courses, but instead they desire to retain their lessons and actively grow from them. In Christ, they are the people who do not simply attend church Sunday and blindly proclaim that they believe in Jesus. Instead, they intentionally spend time both in prayer and the Bible regularly in order to develop a deep relationship with their Lord. It is this effort and passion that I find in people so inspiring. On the other hand, there's also the loving. They continually focus on other people's needs instead of their own, and they constantly take a posture of humility and a willingness to meet people where they are at, even when they are in dark and low places. Such selfless people love others the way Christ did, who laid down his life with all its pleasures and beauty for others. The people who do likewise, I also find inspiring. However, the people I find most influential, most impactful, are the people who are both. The people who are both earnest and loving. I believe the best way I can describe this is by citing examples. My first example is no better than Christ himself. Christ, on this earth, was held to a high standard. But additionally, he had a high purpose. He had the cross. And even though he was intent and resolute on accomplishing the task on the cross and wouldn't stop till it was finished, along the way, he displayed love. He would heal the sick. He'd restore the sight of the blind. He even helped a group of fishermen well when they weren't having the best fishing day ever. But he never stopped there. Whenever he helped someone, he always invited them to follow him. And he told them the journey would be hard, ridiculously hard. But if they followed him, they would approach that more perfection standard that he was at. Likewise, we should also earnestly strive to be better and help those around us succeed as well. I'd like to cite one more example. At SHS, a staff member who I believe who has helped embody this example is Coach Schuster. Coach Schuster tries to further his family life and pursues education and makes sure his family stable before he goes on his life, trying to be a good father and a good leader. Yet, along in his classroom, he earnestly pushes those around him to do the same. He'll be kind to those who need kindness, but when those are not trying, he clearly rebukes them. And it is this love and sincerity that I believe has the power to change people's lives. Granted, these changes may be small, but is not life just a series of small changes, either for the better or for the worse? So once again, I encourage us all to take a deep look at the people around us who stood out from the rest. Ask ourselves why they stood out from the rest, and then imitate the virtues those people have. If we actively try to do so, we can make a difference, one small change at a time. Again, thank you, everyone. And congratulations.
Good morning, Phoenix family and friends. Pastor Rick Warren said, "Your character is the sum total of your habits." This means who you are as a person is shaped by the habits you cultivate and consistently practice. Students, as you continue the journey in becoming your best self, I encourage you to make the following behaviors a routine part of your words and your deeds: honesty and humility, compassion and care, gratitude and grace, respect and responsibility, fairness and forgiveness, love and laughter. If you make it a habit to demonstrate these attributes, you will experience a life filled with joy and contentment. And this is my greatest wish for each of you. May your lives reflect the words of 1 Corinthians 16:14. Let all that you do be done in love. The world is waiting for your kindness and your love, so go forth and make it a better place. Superintendent Mrs. Mashburn and members of the Board of Education of Gordon County Schools, on behalf of the faculty and staff of Sonoraville High School, it is with great pride and enthusiasm that I present the class of 2024. I certify on this day, May the 25th, that these students have met the requirements set forth by the Georgia Department of Education. I hereby recommend the members of this class presented to you today as qualified candidates for a Georgia High School diploma.
Good morning. I'm Alice Mashburn, Superintendent of Gordon County Schools. On behalf of the Board of Education, I hereby accept Mrs. Stewart's recommendation and certify that these students of Sonoraville High School have met all the requirements put forth by the Gordon County Board of Education and the Georgia Department of Education. Congratulations, graduates. Paul John Duhame with highest honors. Eli Ross Stewart with highest honors. Hannah Estelle Jones with highest honors. Brock Jeffrey Clements with highest honors. Julian Aguilar with highest honors. Kaylee Yvonne Ballou with highest honors. Hunter Vance Bearden with highest honors. Dalen Cole Belcher with highest honors. Ashton Dwayne Blunt with highest honors. Ivy Ray Bone with highest honors.
Riley Reese Brewer with highest honors. Aaron Michael Brito with highest honors. Miranda Noelle Brito with highest honors. Ty Christopher Brown with highest honors. Clara Margaret Bryan with highest honors. Ashley Elaine Burnett with highest honors. Luke Evan Caldwell with highest honors. Santiago Yvonne Conchola with highest honors. Blake Cameron Cole with highest honors. Kara Jewel Cordell with highest honors. Hoyt Jackson Darnell with highest honors. Jonathan Delcid Rodriguez with highest honors. Joanna Paige Dempsey with highest honors. Riley Madison Derryberry with highest honors. Magdalene Therese Duhame with highest honors. William Rowan Dunaway with highest honors. McKinley Grace Fuller with highest honors. Briston Delaney Gordon with highest honors. Jessara Lene Gray Lott with highest honors. Caitlin Elaine Griffith with highest honors. Jessica Jocelyn Hernandez with highest honors. Caden Scott Harrington with highest honors. Haley Nicole Holcomb with highest honors. Alexa Nicole Hopkins with highest honors. Kylie Shay Hurd with highest honors. Kaylee Arizeth Jacobo with highest honors. Logan Shaylin Yagela with highest honors. Claudia Isabel Jasso with highest honors. Ella McDowell Jenkins with highest honors. Ethan Burr Kellogg with highest honors. Wyatt Edward Key with highest honors. Janie Kate King with highest honors. Nora Sonnet Kincaid with highest honors. Sullivan Taylor Knight with highest honors. Ava Grace Lambert with highest honors. Janelle Yanari Lopez with highest honors. Maggie Rose Marchman with highest honors. Donovan James McDaniel with highest honors. Jackson Bragg McGill with highest honors. Ansley Caroline Miller with highest honors. Brian Zachary Alexander Mulkey with highest honors. Magdalene Grace Myers with highest honors. Jaden Nin Nguyen with highest honors. Ruth Abigail Nunfio with highest honors. Vania Palmarine Cervantes with highest honors. Tristan Raven Parker with highest honors. Grace Deshay Parrott with highest honors. Jackson Trent Pate with highest honors. Xander Lee Ralston with highest honors. Gavin Wade Reese with highest honors. Caitlin Sky Rexrode with highest honors. Andrew William Albert Richardson with highest honors. John Gregory Ridley with highest honors. Molly Rebecca Roberts with highest honors. Brittany Vanessa Romero with highest honors. Carter Christopher Sampson with highest honors. Kyler Lamar Sampson with highest honors. Emily Joanna Sanchez with highest honors. Giovanna Nicole Sicaros with highest honors. Abigail Joyce Smith with highest honors. Emily Hope Smith with highest honors. Gavin Barton Smith with highest honors. Caden Martin Stover with highest honors. William Boyd Thomas with highest honors. Rebecca Elizabeth Tippett with highest honors. Kayla Tirador with highest honors. Isabel Rose Uliberry with highest honors. Joshua Blake Walden with highest honors. Valencia Bell Walden with highest honors. Brinley McLean Walraven with highest honors. Jamie Daniela Wilson with highest honors. Maylee Amber Wooten with highest honors. Thomas Franklin Young with highest honors. Aileen Aguilar. Mason Akers. Pierce William Aldridge. Memory Paulette Amix. Lauren Marie Anderson. Talon Hugh Arguello. Christopher Hunter Autry. Shaylin Faith Bailey. Chad Austin Bates. Lizeth Bautista. Joshua Thomas Benoit. Calla Nicole Black. Joshua David Bonds. Stephen Chase Bonds. Carson Renee Bone. Casey Aaliyah Bradley. Skylar Allen Bradley. Chance Edward Brookshire. Hannah Nicole Birchfield. Sailor Owen Cagle. Kaylee Marie Carnes. Hannah Claire Darlene Carr. Cody B. Carroll. Mark Connor Carroll. Ronald Abram Carter. Caitlin Bonnie Shamley. Ricky Marie Ann Churchill. Brooklyn Lee Clark. Charles Cole Collins. Nathaniel Garson Cornwell. Simon Franklin Craddock. Waylon Hayden Crane. Megan Elizabeth Crook. DeMarcus Travion Davenport. Cooper Gabriel DeArc. Faith Michelle Dowdy. Dayson Logan Davis Dress. Berdiana Ruby Duarte. Wesley Keith Duncan. Richard Jackson Dupree. Caitlin Cheyenne Dye. Kaylin Renee Dyer. Jalen Ann Edge. Chloe Renee Edmonds. Ariel Brock Finley. Brooklyn Michelle Fisher. Anthony Freddy Flores. Destiny Elizabeth Frazier. Charles Wyatt Fuller. Brian James Fung. Kevin No Garcia. Leticia Noelia Garcia. Audrey Renee Gentry. Tyson Lane Jarab. Mackenzie Lee Gilbert. Daniel Patrick Gillette. Braxton Lee Goldston. Jose Anthony Gonzalez Moreno. Charles Tristan Gordon. Skylar Scotland McKenzie Guyton. Emma Lou Hall. Veronica Juliana Hawkins. Danielle Faith Lynette Heath. Jesse Clinton Hendricks. Anastasia Lynn Henley. Isaiah Germond Henry. Daisy Hernandez. Zachary Daniel Hill. Samuel Isaiah Hickson. Oh.
Connor Charles Hogan. Sierra Rose Halbert. Skyler Garrett Holland. Emma Loren Holt. Stephen Michael Hubbard. Zoe Elizabeth Hufstetler. Tyler Jackson Hughes. Jalen Nevea Hunter. John Harley Jackson. Callista Laney Jarvis. Landon Matthew Jarvis. Brett Nolan Johns. Tucker Miles Johnson. Madison Marie Johnston. Brooke Elise Jones. Joshua Layton Jones. David Juarez. Samuel Dirk Junkins. Keegan Daly Kinkala. Karis Jalen Kelly. William Dale Lambert. Colton Fisher Lance. Kenneth Paxton Lanier. Michael Caden Lau. Noah Lee Lincoln. Dawson Dean Lingerfeld. Cadence Cheyenne Lockard. Benjamin Caleb Levain. Mackenzie Elizabeth Luna. Caden Alexander Lynch. Riley Jane Maines. Hector Rafael Martinez. Carson Matthew McIntyre. Jason Tyler McGee. Emily Rose McGill. Cadence Jade McReynolds. Alana Rain Aaliyah Meadows. Daniel Scott Miller. David Monroy. Logan Blake Moore. Charlie Morales. Jimena Isabel Mortaya. Caden McCoy Mulkey. Fabian McLean Mulkey. Elena Christine Mull. Taylor James Mullins. Jameson Bryce Nelson. Carmen Marie Newberry. Jaden Dawn Nicholson. Jesus Nunez. Thomas Jacob Oliver. Trenton Scott Parker. Brandon Christopher Para Torres. Cameron Blaine Pasley. Madison Michelle Patterson. Olivia Gabrielle Patterson. Charity Catalina Perez. Alexis Perez Hijon. Angel Alcides Perla. Memphis Alexander Polly. Bryson Lee Privet. Stanley Xavier Proper. Taylor Yvonne Pryor. Daisy Ramirez. Vincent Alexander Ray. Brianna Nicole Renner. Race Peyton Rich. Jasmine Lynn Richmond. Lainey Grace Rickett. Ellen Ames Robertson. Somaiti Yvette Rodriguez. Haley Brianna Rogers. Kaylee Renee Sanders. Isaac Michael Scott. Kason Lee Allen Shaw. Anthony Bryson Owen Shelnut. Coley Elizabeth Silvers. Landon Edward Silvers. Jenny Tennessee Mahaley Singer. Ashton Lee Smith. Cecil Riley Smith. Rachel Amelia Reed. Chandler J. Smith. Joshua Eli Smith. Chelsea Leanne Spear. Emma Catherine Springfield. Thomas Samuel Spruill. Ryland Walker Stamey. Dominique Isaiah Zane Sean Stepp. Corbin Hunter Stevens. Gracie Marie Stone. Jordan Lamar Story. Joseph Alec Strickland. Mackenzie Ashlyn Suddeth. Josue Tabuada Hernandez. Jamiria Nicole Taylor. Daniel James Thompson. Fatima Toledo Anguano. Keegan Isaiah Townsend. Grace Lynn Trivette. Jorge Adrian Vega Balbino. Hayden Thomas Venuti.
Go Hayden!
Nayeli Lisbeth Vigil Rodriguez. Alexis Michelle Watson. Destiny Sienna Weaver. Ethan Avery Weaver. Levi Jaden Shane West. Levi Casey White. Jada Madison Whitfield. Auburn Wesley Glenn Williams. Savannah Faith Williams. Skylar Nicole Woodward. Travell James Thomas Moses Wynn. Cephas Ethan Bailey in memoriam.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen in the class of 2024. My name is Brock Clements, and it's been an honor to serve as your class president this past year. I'd like to start by thanking the faculty and staff of Sonoraville Elementary School, Redbud Middle School, and Sonoraville High School for guiding me down the right path throughout my education. Thank you to all the coaches in the past 18 years. Whether that be in football or in baseball, you all have taught me that talent means nothing without hard work. I'd like to give a special thank you to Coach Schuster, Carmelita Everett, and Ms. Judy Craig for all their support they have given me these past 4 years. And a big thank you to Coach Warhaven, Coach Henderson, Coach Pruitt, Coach Lyles, and Coach Patterson for being great role models for me on and off the field. Lastly, I would like to thank my mom, Kim Pruitt, my dad, Jeff Clements, for always supporting and believing in me no matter what, and for shaping me into the young man that I am today. None of this will be possible without my family by my side. I have many family members in attendance today. To my grandparents, siblings, and parents, thank you for everything you have done for me over the past years. And to my baseball guys out there, we've made an impact and left a legacy at the school. Thank you all for being my brothers on and off the field. Class 2024, we made it. As we get ready to say goodbye to this place we've called home for the past 4 years, let's not forget the lessons we've learned and the friendships we've made. Let us carry those on with us to the next chapter. There's a quote by Jonathan Lockwood Huey that really sums up where we are in life at this moment. He says, "Celebrate endings, for they precede new beginnings." Our time at Sonoraville High School is ending, but there are so many possibilities in front of us. Whether you're going into college, into the military, or straight into work, the opportunities for us are endless. In a few short minutes, this will all be over, and the easiest time of our lives will be coming to an end. But before this happens, I want to challenge each and every one of you to keep God first in your life and to seek to make a difference in the world around you. As Winston Churchill said, we make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give. Be kind and help others whenever you can. Now, at this time, Class of 2024, please join me in turning your tassel from your right side to your left. Fellow classmates, work hard in all that you do, enjoy life, and go Phoenix.
If I could have everyone please stand for the singing of the alma mater.
Please remain standing for retiring of colors. Permission granted. Work.
Congratulations, graduates. I'm so proud to have served as your principal for the last 4 years. The class of 2024 comes from many communities in the eastern side of Gordon County. Ranger, Oakman, Nicholsville, Pine Chapel, Owens Gin, Sonoraville, Redbud, Union Grove, Cache, Deuce Pond, Boone Ford, Newtown, Talking Rock, Bellwood, Irwin Hill, Folsom, Fairmount, Rydell, and Farmville. And no matter where your past may lead in the future, Sonoraville High School will always be your home. So families, I'm gonna set up the cap toss for you, so if you wanna get your phones ready to take the photo. The students are gonna join me in saying our school mission statement, and at the end, they'll give a hearty go Phoenix, and as soon as we say the word Phoenix, they'll toss their cap. So if you wanna get your phones ready for that photo. All right, students, here we go. At Sonoraville High School, we are a learning community actively pursuing a higher standard of excellence. Remember to be kind and make good choices. Have a wonderful life and future. And go Phoenix!
Yeah. Good afternoon, graduates and guests. At this time, make your way to the exit doors located on your west side and also your southwest side. In preparation for the next commencement that will begin shortly, please leave the